Welcome. Philadelphia, the fifth largest big city in the United States and the first largest poor city. Now, I ask you, is it because of the people, the residents, the taxpayers in this city? Or have the politicians gambled with the resources of our city and failed? When we come back, we'll talk about it. Your host, Melvin Prince Johnakin. Everybody plays the fool sometimes. There's no exception to the rule. Beyond the sky, it's been a long time coming, but I know. Welcome back to The Gamble That Failed. Your host, Melvin Prince Johnakin. So let's talk. Let's see how the gamble has failed in Philadelphia. As it stands today, we have approximately 265 murders. We have 609 shootings. We have a police chief who has zero experience handling a police force of 6,500 people. So, tell me the process. Call up and tell me what it takes when you're a police chief. Oh, I bet some of you don't know. So did the mayor gamble on a question of, is this police chief qualified? Or did he give us what he wanted us to have, knowing she was not qualified? Tell you what, call in and let's talk about it. It is very important because we can ill afford to lose one more child or one more adult in the city through gun violence. So you want to take all the guns out? Does that solve the problem? Oh. You want to give them money. Does that solve the problem? Oh, you want a commissioner that knows what she's doing or what he is doing. That might solve the problem. But as it stands right now, this gamble has failed. We're going to take a break. And when we come back, we'll talk more about it. We're back, and this is another segment of The Gamble That Failed. Your host, Melvin Prince Johnakin. There were a number of calls asking, why do they hire and employ Black and Latino people? And I said, it's quite simple. You are the commodity Well, the commodity of the day is Black and Latino people. And so, for instance, let's say you graduate from college, age 22 to 24, maybe 26 if you have much fun. And let's say you get your job based on your senior year and you having an interview and having an internship, and that company decides to retain you. Well, like most people, you're working between the age of 24 and 34, or 24 and 36. And it's good to have a job, but then you acquire certain things. So you may have your first apartment, you may meet a young lady, you may have your first child, you may get married, move out of that apartment and move into a house. Well, that's the progression of how things go. But between 36 and 40, that first job that you retained out of college, you usually lose that job. And now you're unemployed. Car note, insurance, wife, children. And don't act like you don't know what I'm talking about. Most of you have gone down this road right here. So I just want to give you some clarity on the road you're going down, and then possibly give you an idea on how to handle this so your children don't go down this same path. But when you are let go at 36, between 36 and 40, in your job, searching for another job, you find out that at this point in time, your job experience really doesn't carry that much weight. Because whatever they were paying you, they now have hired somebody else coming out of college, and they're paying them half, who has none of the experiences that you've learned on this job. So what do? Well, you go looking for another job. And almost 75% of you take another job to pay the bills that has nothing to do with the degree you have. You got an accounting degree? Well, you're driving for Uber or Lyft. You have a business management degree? Oh, well, you're working at Walmart just to pay the bills that you have. I mean, most folks want to live in a house that they now are paying a mortgage on, and they want the kids to go to the school that they have been going to. So you don't want to disrupt your family apple cart, so you take a job, whatever's paying you. Some folks do construction who have never done it before. Right. But you do not do it for a long period of time. So now you're 40. And let's say you do that job for 10 years. You can no longer do construction late into your 50s because it's a difficult job. You can no longer drive as far as you used to drive in your 50s because your prostate, you gotta go to the bathroom from time to time. So what happens is that you've been conditioned to work and to be a part of a system that have either tax credit you in, subsidized you in, with no way out, and convince you that they were economically going to take care of you until you find out the hard way. The hard way is almost like picking up that one day and realizing that it was your parents who bought you Christmas, who bought you toys, not Santa Claus. The problem is, why would you tell them from the very beginning that there is a Santa Claus? So we need to explore that some. And we need to take a hard look at that, because during this pandemic, we had folks working at McDonald's, Wendy's, Burger King, some of these multi-billion dollar fast food companies, and they did not get essential pay. How are you serving more food through Grubhub or through Uber Eats, different entities? You're producing more food during a pandemic, and yet you're not getting any more money. Matter of fact, the president that you just elected has failed to sign a bill to pay you $15 an hour. So you need to look at this. And as much as you tune in to me, I'll share as much as I can with you. But you need a day where you walk off the job. You need a day where you leave. You can't continue to stay in this predicament. You will, in the next 20 years, cease to have any meaningful, sustainable opportunity in the city of Philadelphia. They've built you out of the equation. Do you realize that you can go into a bank on Huntington Park, walk up to the kiosk, talk to a teller you don't see, and they do everything from somewhere else? Go to Bank of America. You don't have to talk to anybody. Soon you'll be able to buy groceries that way. Soon you'll be able to walk in Walmart that way. Soon you'll be able to walk in Target and do the same thing. You know why? Because then they don't have to worry about nobody stealing stuff out the stores. They don't have to worry about hiring somebody to check your receipt and make sure all the items are there. Although it's insured, although it gets paid, they don't really have a need. The more technology is in play, the less they have a need for human error or human personalities or human relationship. So I tell you what, we're going to put a pin in it. I'm going to take a break and we're going to come back. You're now focused in on The Gamble That Failed, hosted by Melvin Prince Johnakin. Hey, thank you for tuning in. I'm sure we shared a lot. I look forward to your tweets. I look forward to your emails, your line of communication. And until we meet again, be safe and be independent. Goodbye.